Hello, everyone. We're bringing it back for some bonus content today. Since you're being so patient for the next full build, we've got another big rig unboxing. I know you guys love these trucks, and that's the ones we'll do the unboxings on for the bonus content. You can check them out. This is available right now. I will link in the description where you can snag yours. This is AMT's 125th scale Chevy Bison, extremely similar to the 132nd scale Bison I built, but instead of being a quick snap kit, this is a more advanced modeler's kit with over 300 parts, builds to almost 13 inches long. We've got some color options in here. We got the white, we got the red, and on the box is a really cool color guide for your model right on the side there. So they give you some tips on there. They give you some nice color interior drawings. You'll be able to get that thing, and then they give you the real world designations and sizes and everything, the big Detroit diesel. So this thing would have been loud out on the streets. And we are going to take a look at everything that's in the box. First up is what I call the multimedia. This is all of our clear parts. We've got our windshield and door glass all in one. Of course, you could cut that if you wished. We've got headlights, back glass, and the passenger sight glass there. Nice and clear. You can see my name through there. Then we've got two sets of transparent yellow for our marker lights and turn signals, and then we've got transparent red for our tail lights on the cab. We've also got a beautiful full set of decals to allow you to replicate the box art. You can really see it on the side with the white one there, but these decals will allow you to paint one color on your cab and hood and fenders and duplicate it with these decals. We've got our registration callouts in black and white. We've got our fleet numbers in black and white. We got some Great Plains sand and gravel logos. We've got Chevrolet truck logos for the mud flaps. We've got a beautiful set of dash gauges, and then a whole bunch of license plate, Bison emblems, and state registration stickers with, of course, the AMT cats on the outside. Also rounding up our multimedia part of the kit are these two very big chrome trees. We've got our grill surround. We've got our smokestacks. Some black wash in here will help quite a bit. We've got individual windshield wipers. We've got marker lights. We've got air horns and a nice bow tie on that one. We're going to need some black wash in that grill as well. Paint really won't do it. It's a little too thick. And then we've got our wheels and our fenders, our front fenders, which are always these parts right here. And then we have mud flaps on the back. We've got a beautiful chrome bumper, trim rings for the front wheels. We've got our rear wheels and our front wheels there. We've got exhaust parts, individual pieces for the mirrors. Got our cab marker lights, air cleaners, and our antennae off the mirror. So be very, very careful when you cut those apart. Those are your chrome trees. Then we've got, of course, 10 tires. These are pad printed Firestones. Great tread pattern. This is a new mold with pad printing. Check out the sizes are in there and everything. On the backside, they are black wall. So if you don't like Firestone tires, or you don't want white wall or white letter tires on your rig, do that and you'll be fine. So you got 10 of those nice little bad boys in there. And then we've got our instruction manual. Now, we've got parts listing, which is a parts blowout, which is not usually included with a lot of these kits. Sometimes they include it on the box, but this one's going to have it right here. And we've got our engine. Now, this is an AMT kit. It will be a little more challenging than the Ertl ones that I've been showing you for all these unboxings. But go ahead, build it up. Won't be too difficult, but try to take your time, because there will be some fiddling. There will be some custom fitting on all of these kits. All right, they're not just going to fall together. They're not going to go together super easy. These are more of an advanced modeler's model kit. Now, I'm going to grab the other parts in the model, and I'll be back in just a moment. Thank you. Next up are all the white styrene parts in the model. We can see these beautiful frame rails molded perfectly straight. We've got location marks on the inside of the frames all the way across. This is where all your cross members and parts will go on the insides. And then on the outside, of course, you're going to have all the holes, all the little location marks, all the indents, all the grooves to mount everything else you need, your springs and everything on the model. Over 300 parts, so you always got to watch out a little bit. We've got our radiator surround here. We've got the mount for our fifth wheel and our fifth wheel and its actual mount. We've got our front axle. You can see how nice and heavy duty that is. We've got our springs and their mounts on this one. Shock absorbers, our two drive shafts from the end, from the transmission to the differential and between the differentials. We've got our springs for the front. We've got our two differentials all mounted up on there. And these trees can be a little fragile, so be careful. On this one here, we've got our tanks. I like that they're molded in white so that the modeler can decide. You've seen me test out chrome spray paints. If you haven't, look up that video, spray paint, chrome spray paint showdown on the channel. You'll get a good view of everything. We've got our batteries and even cables on here, battery boxes, tank ends. I really like that this is in plastic and not chrome. We got our frame cross members. We've got our mud flaps, transmission, suspension components here, the airbag suspension, brake equipment, all on that nice big tree right there. On this one, we've got more mounts. We've got the nice seats. They look pretty comfy. Could use a little more padding for long haulers. Wheel trim rings, looks like air cleaner. Firewall is very, very detailed on this one. So we've got a nice parts tree right there, front seats, seat backs. On this one, we've got the rest of our trim rings. I'm really glad they're in white plastic because when they're in chrome, they tend to split. We've got the halves of our Detroit diesel. And we've got our cylinder heads, valve covers, oil pan, belt and pulley, the massive cooling fan. We've got all of our small parts here. We've got our brake drums on the back, manifolds for that V8. That would be a screamer going down the street with its 13-speed transmission. Then we've got some sleeper parts on the back, very small sleeper on this one. We've got the door handles molded in, all the seams on there, only a couple rivets on this one. Pretty smooth. On this tree, we've got an optional visor. I love how those look. We've got our transmission, rest of our battery boxes, the dashboard. With the decals that are included, you do not need to sand any of this off. You could choose to hand paint it or lay that decal over it with some decal solvent. It'll go in there, and these are nice and shallow, so it will look completely 3D. Got our CB radio. Got our steering wheel in there. Various small trim pieces. Looks like our headliner on that tree. And then we've got the rest of our sleeper. We've got our air dam up here. Our spoiler for the roof. Exhaust pieces and hoses. And then let's get out the remainder. We've got our cab parts. We've got our interior. The interior does have the door panels molded in. It is shallow detail, but it is enough to detail. It's just a tan interior. Very simple. It's got carpet mold in, seat mounts, and this door panel's a little smaller because they got to have that sight window in there. So that's why that's molded open like that. We've got our front fenders, our separate pieces, which will go on either side of the hood, and you can see that they will mate up quite nicely. Bead of glue run in there. Thin liquid glue. I like Plastruct bonding that you see on all my videos. So we've got our front fenders, and they will mount nicely with our turn signal holes already on the roof. And then we've got our squared off Chevy Bison hood, or GMC General, whatever you prefer for logos. I'm sure there's aftermarket logos that could help you out with that. And then finally, we've got our cab, doors, got their hinges in them, open pieces for the exhaust, mirrors, grab handles on the back. We've got our opening. You can put the window in there or the sleeper on the back. So you can run the day cab or a sleeper. And that is it. That's all the awesome parts, over 300 of them that are in the Bison kit. I want to thank you guys for being patient. If everything goes well, we will have the full build of that 55 Bel Air tomorrow. As always, I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending over the kits for their reviews. And I want to thank you for watching the videos. Thumbs up, questions, comments, and concerns in the comment section. Again, the kit will be linked down in the description. And I will see all of you for a video tomorrow.